Here's some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Nokia after it announced a $653 million share buyback program this quarter after reporting that its profit plunged in 2023. The results, however, beat estimates. Shares of Nokia jumped 7.5%. Also in focus, shares of embattled plane maker Boeing after the U.S. Federal Aviation Administration paused the company's 737 MAX production expansion, although it cleared a path to bring the MAX 9 back into service. Boeing shares slid over 2.5% in the pre-market. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Microsoft, whose stock market value crossed the $3 trillion threshold for the first time, becoming only the second company to do so after Apple. Microsoft shares are slightly down before the bell.
Asian markets saw another mixed end to trade. The Shanghai Composite rose 3%, its largest daily gain in nearly 2 years. That's after the Chinese government announced more policy support. The Hong Kong Hang Seng also jumped 2%. That's despite a drag from electric vehicle makers. Chinese EV firms trading in Hong Kong saw sharp losses after an earnings miss from Tesla raised concerns over a slowdown in global demand. Tesla suppliers listed elsewhere in Asia also fell. Here at home, Philippine shares snapped a three-day winning streak with the main index falling 0.1%.
The Philippines' central bank registered foreign investments or hot money showed an outflow of $247 million for 2023. That's a reversal from the over $886 million worth of net inflows from 2022. The BSP says majority of the outflows represented capital repatriation. The U.S. continued to be the main destination of the outflows. For the top investors in the country in 2023, these are the U.K., U.S., Singapore, Luxembourg, and Japan.
The Philippine Trade Department is studying ways to protect consumers from the negative impact of shrinkflation. Now, shrinkflation is when manufacturers reduce the size or weight of their products to cope with rising costs, but the price stays the same. The agency is also looking at the possibility of requiring retailers to put up signages to alert consumers of products affected by shrinkflation.
Yung size ng lata, kapag 155 grams or 130 grams, halos pareho lang. So para ma-highlight yon at right to information ng consumers natin ay maiproteksyonan, yan yung pinag-aaralan natin ngayon sa DTI. Kung manufacturer, then ilalagay siya sa pakete, sa labeling, sa packaging. Kung retailer, then ilalagay siya sa shelf as a signage.
Here are some local corporate headlines. Price Corporation fires the opening salvo for the earnings season as it reports a 32% surge in its 2023 bottom line to $2.2 billion. The company says strong sales volume of LPG and improving margins helped to offset the drop in its average contract price. Price's earnings per share for 2023 also up 32% to 1 peso and 7 centavos from 81 centavos in 2022. And Philinvest Development Corporation completes the payment of its 10-year fixed-rate retail bonds in the aggregate amount of 8.8 billion pesos. The bonds were issued by the company on January 24, 2014 and matured Wednesday.